Welcome to Design a Move, a weekly functional movement series reviewing common movement impairment syndromes, muscle imbalances, and injury cycles, and how to correct for them. Don't just exercise, but restore optimal movement. Hey everybody, this is Ryan Maxwell. I'm a movement specialist here with Fluid Health and Fitness, and today we're going to go over atlanto-occipital instability and forward head posture. Global distortion from our posture leads to an apexing of tension around the skull and where it meets up with the neck. So today we're going to show you how to correct for that. If you have questions on the issue, make sure to reach out to us at admin@fluidhealthandfitness.com. Recognize we do have a blog on the series, so you're welcome to read that. It's in the description below. And we have a table of contents to the side if you want to skip to any of our segments or the condensed version of the video at the bottom. Let's get started. First segment has to do with mobility and release. We're going to be releasing the overactive muscles around the neck, primarily the sternocleidomastoids and the suboccipital muscles. You're only gonna use your body weight for this, so let's get started. So Ryan's gonna do a release using a pincer grip with his fingers of his sternocleidomastoid. He's using his fingers. You're gonna identify the muscle again by turning the head to the side. Gently push your head back. It attaches from the mastoid to the clavicle, and you'll feel it flex there. Using your fingertips, he's gonna grab the base of that muscle, making sure not to push into the neck. Get a firm grip on it, turn your head back to neutral, and then while holding it under pressure, he's slowly gonna breathe out, tilt his head to the opposite side of the body, and look up to the opposite side, slowly letting that muscle floss between his fingertips. At the end of that stretch, he'll come back to neutral again, regain another grip, hold it there, and then draw it down. These muscles attach the clavicle to the base of the skull, and when they're tight, they pull the skull forward, so it's good to reduce these so that the head can glide back over the spine and maintain the natural positioning of the skull. You're gonna wanna hold this for 30 to 60 seconds, and we go through multiple active releases, maybe 6 to 10, and then we'll move into the next segment. The next muscle that we're gonna release is the suboccipital muscles. These are the small muscles at the base of the skull that attach the first two vertebrae, the atlas and axis, hence the atlanto-occipital instability. When the muscles are too taut, the head kicks back into excess extension, and again, the muscle action is extension and rotation. So to reduce these muscles, we're going to take our fingertips, place them right under the little processes of our skull. You'll feel those little bony protuberances right on the side of the skull. Push gently in towards that area. Breathe out, gently tuck your chin down, and then rotate the head to the opposite hemisphere of the body. As you do that, breathe out, guide your eyes downward as you look down, and you'll feel the pressure of those muscles slide under your fingertips. Obviously, there's some very delicate nerve areas in the neck, so we want to be very gentle with this. You want very passive, soft pressure being applied. And again, use your breathing pattern to help to reduce this. You're going to target both sides. Make sure to go through the active release after about 30 seconds of pressure being exerted, and then move into the breathing and the movement. All said and done, you should go through about 6 to 10 breathing cycles, and then we'll move into our activation. Now we're gonna get into our activation segment. We're gonna be working the deep cervical flexors, coleocapitus muscles that are attached on the anterior portion of our spine. We're gonna be in a 4-point quad position. Let's get down there. Now that we've reduced your superficial flexors, the sternocleidomastoid and the suboccipitals as the extensors, we wanna start to teach you how to bring the head back over into a natural position over the rib cage. You'll notice that Ryan is descending his head, going into extension, letting his head fall forward towards the floor, and then pulling his chin into his neck, lifting his head upright to match the height of his rib line. As he does that, notice that he's not kicking his head back into extension, bringing his chin up, but bringing it down. And again, keeping his shoulder blade stable by keeping his palms directly under his shoulders and pushing through them to lock those shoulders into a fixed position. That'll give you more engagement or facilitation of these deep cervical flexors. He's gonna take it down nice and slow as his head drops down to a count of four, hold it there for a count, and then bring it up to an upright flexed position. And he's gonna go through 20 repetitions, wait 45 seconds, recover, and then do it again. This is going to bring us to the end of our activation. Now let's get into our integration section. Let's get started. Our second to last segment is going to be on integration. This is an upregulation of the central nervous system when we put all the pieces together. And again, we're going to be in a laying position on the ground doing a cobra with cervical flexion. Let's get back down there. He's using a back extension while co-contracting the deep flexors of the cervical spine. Ryan's gonna come up off the ground by lifting his chest off the ground, draw his shoulder blades back and around the rib cage while maintaining that depressed chin position. He's able to maintain a neutral cervical alignment and he's activating the back musculature. When you extend through the lumbar spine, it lengthens the spine and allows you an easier glide of the head back over the rib cage. So we wanna teach the body how to maintain this position. So the action would be to come up and hold the flexed position and then let the body weight drop down, allowing the shoulders to come back down. If the head is gliding forward and there is extra glide in that skull, there's a good chance that the shoulders are gonna fall forward and you're gonna go into your pectoral girdle, bringing the shoulders forward. So the co-contracture of the retractors of the scapula, along with the extensors of the lower back and the deep cervical flexors, will help to create a neutral spinal alignment. You're gonna wanna go through two sets of 20 repetitions, a nice slow controlled descent towards the floor, and again, a more dynamic upward position, but make sure you keep your shoulders back and down while keeping the chin depressed. That'll bring us to the end of our integration. We'll finish with a strength movement. For our final segment, we're gonna strengthen the muscles around the neck using an exercise band. You're gonna need two of those, a heavier band and a lighter band. This is gonna again recruit the cervical flexors, but now we're gonna coordinate the scapular retractors. Let's get started. So the last strength movement is gonna use two exercise bands. Ryan's gonna put the stronger of the two bands around the base of his head. Just like the four point, he's gonna tuck his chin and pull his head back over his rib cage. There's sufficient tension here and the band is just about at the eye line. He could squat down just a little bit too. We're trying to keep the neutral alignment through the spine. And while maintaining that fixed cervical flexion, he's gonna start to pull his arms and shoulder blades around a fixed rib cage. So he's gonna breathe out, pulling the arms in discaption and depression, breathe in and let them glide forward. This is intermuscular coordination of the deep cervical flexors with the scapular retractors and depressors, the rhomboids and lower mid trapezius. The engagement of these two sets of muscles help to maintain the neutral alignment of the thoracic portion of the spine, again, the portion of the spine that's connected to the rib cage, along with maintaining the neutral alignment of the head over the rib cage. All said and done, all of this will help to maintain a neutral position, get that head back to where it belongs, and reduce that forward head posture that leads to the instability at the atlanto-occipital joint. He's gonna go through two sets of 20 repetitions, a slow opening of the shoulders forward, and then again, a more decisive retraction, all the while making sure that the head doesn't tilt forward or the shoulders roll up at the bottom or the top of the arm movement. If you want more information on how your everyday postures can lead to this altered biomechanical state, make sure to refer to the blog in the description below. And that brings us to the end of this segment. It's important to remember that the muscles that shroud your neck and attach your head to your spine are evenly balanced so that the center of your head is over your spine. By doing these exercises today, we're gonna help to restore the natural balance of your skull on the spine, reduce the chances of bulging disc and extra issues around the neck, and increase your quality of life along with upregulating your central nervous system. So make sure to stay with it. On behalf of Fluid Health and Fitness, again, thank you for coming and joining us today. Remember, your body's designed to move, so stay in action and we'll see you next time.